Initially, when Life Scout Cain Brandon performed a weekly dump of his Troop 167 B.S.A.'s fundraising cans, he saw positivity.
Sending the boys out to go camping. That way, they don't have to pay a fee themselves.
Also, his goals of funding his Eagle Scout project of a map board at the cemetery.
It'll tell people where their friends and families if they want to go pay respects or leave flowers for them.
Lately, he sees despair. Thieves are depleting the cage. Most recently, the amount was cut in half.
Every time we take in cans, we get $200-$300 out of the cage. So that was $100-$150 that was lost. You know, that's a few camping trips for all the boys right there.
The Stewart Parks and Rec Department has a smaller cage at Lawbaugh Park where they hope to help pay for farmers market picnic tables and playground equipment, but thieves also set them back on multiple occasions.
Wait a minute. The lock is completely gone. Completely gone. There was nothing, wasn't there, and then they thought they left the can cage door open. And half the pop cans were gone.
The Stewart Police Department has launched an investigation.
You're not just stealing pop cans. You know, you're stealing from good causes, people that are trying to raise this money for good things in the community.
Stewart's Parks and Rec Department says the criminal activity doesn't stop with pop cans. Footprint evidence is still left from a damaged door from an attempted break-in in mid-September.
This building here in the park that they damaged, I mean, it's unnecessary, and now the city's got to pay to fix that and repair things.
Stealing from and damaging a piece of Stewart's future.
Those cans are for a good cause.
Is it going to be for the kids, for, you know, future playground equipment? And it's just not right.
A problem police believe they aren't far away from correcting.
I can't get into details, but I mean, someone will be arrested for this.